Dear students, in the last two modules, we have learned two types of mass storages. One was magnetic systems and the next one was optical systems. So, in today's module, we will start flash drives, which is also one of the mass storage. And that mass storage was mean that we want to store data for long period of time. That should be non-volatile. What were the issues in magnetic systems, whether it was optical system or hard drive magnetic system? So the issues were the physical motion. So you need to rotate the disk, whether it was magnetic system or the optical system. And we also need to move the read write heads in the form of when we used magnetic systems, and we also need to aim the laser beams. So all of these operations are not in line, are not compliant with the electronic circuitry which we have in our computer. So we want something in which we could store data electronically. So this need was adopted by flash drives. So bits are stored by sending electronic signals directly to the storage medium, where they cause electrons to be trapped in tiny chambers of silicon dioxide. So there is no motion of read-write head, or there is no motion of the disk. And chambers are able to store data for years without external power. So you might have also used the flash drives in your daily life. So this is one of the example of flash technology. And then if we repeatedly erase, so it slowly damages the silicon dioxide chambers. Therefore, it is not suitable in place of main memory. So you know, in main memory, we need to store and retrieve data more often. So for example, whenever you open a web browser, or whenever you want to work on computer, so your all of the data and program is stored in the main memory. So this means there you need to read, write, erase data more often. So this means that we cannot use flash drives in the place of main memory, because it slowly damages the silicon dioxide chambers which is available on flash drives. And that is suitable where alterations can be controlled. So there are controlled alterations like cameras. So you take pictures from camera, but you are not all the way every time putting data and taking data out of the camera. And then smartphones, portable devices, so for which you just want to take data from one place to another place. And this is basically the usage of flash drive of today. Because today you have witnessed that we use flash drive to transfer data from one computer to another computer. So that is just a portability. But we are not normally working on flash drives directly. And those are not reliable as optical disk for long term, because it is damaging the chambers. And then there is another concept in the flash drive technology that is called SSDs, solid state disks. So large flash memory devices designed to take place of magnetic disk. So that those have been built and those are being used nowadays, and they have quiet operations. So they do not, because they do not move, disk is not moved, there is no read write head, so the operation is quiet. And their access time is low, as we have already learned that if there is a low access time, then that technology is better than the other one. However, this is costly than the magnetic system. So this is one of the problem at the moment. So researchers are working on it to make cheap SSDs so that it can be adopted in the desktop computers or personal computers. But the business community can use them in place of magnetic systems for quiet operations. and for efficient retrieval as well, because it needs low access time. And then you might have used SD cards, where you insert your card and that card is read. So in SD cards, which is known as basically secure digital memory, so they provide up to few GBs of storage. That also comes under the heading of flash drives. And then they are available in smaller, mini and micro sizes. And then there is another technology known as SDHC, which is secure digital memory with high capacity. And that can provide up till 32 GBs. And then there is SDXC. So XC means extendable capacity. So that may exceed to terabytes. So you can plug in more capacity to it, and it can go up till terabytes. And then compact physical size, suitable for car navigations and cameras, because it is very small in size. You must have seen the SD cards. And if we summarize today's module, where we have learned flash memories and SSDs, SDs, SDHC and SDXC. And there is no physical motion required and suitable for portable devices. So with this, we have completed the modules for mass storage, that how the data is stored permanently on computer rather than using the main memory, which only store data for as long as there is an electricity available.